Every single one of you in this room was made for this moment. You were made for this moment. And it doesn't matter the sport, it matters what you're doing. It matters that you're strapping on pads with your brothers and that you're gonna go do something together, win or go home.
I kind of like to tell the kids, hey, we get a head start. You know, we're gonna start right at midnight. Everybody else is still sleeping. We're gonna go ahead and get started, and just a mentality that goes with that.
Hey, it's August 6th. It's the first day of football practice, and we're practicing at 12 a.m.
We go into practice every day like we should and work hard, meet our goals. I think we should play 13 games this year.
All we want, 13 games.
A midnight practice is about as exciting as a practice can get. The Vikings would condition frequently. The team even had National Guard help condition them during the summer.
I laughed because first day we had 18 kids throw up. I looked at our trainer and said, is this too much? And she goes, I don't know. And I go, God, I've never seen something quite like it.
What would a football practice be without conditioning? Whether it be sleds or the old-fashioned running end line to end line, the Vikings always want to ensure they are better conditioned team on Friday nights. Just before the season opener against Seward, a scrimmage is put on to show the community what they've got before they put their weapons to the test. After the scrimmage, which involved no puking this time around, the Vikings were prepared as ever for their opener at Seward.
All right, if you ain't first, you're last. All right, let's get it. Hey, let's go. Hey, 13 out there, 1, 2, 3.
13.
It's about how we play. It's not about how they talk. It's how we play. When they hit us, because they will hit us, you get up and you hit them back.
Here we go, hit the field late. One day late. One day late. One day late. One day late.
Seward took a 21-0 lead over the Vikings early on. A Caleb Kanoyer touchdown just before halftime gave them some confidence heading into the locker room. Comeback in the second half meant the Vikings needed 8 points to tie the game. Unfortunately, that comeback had come too late.
Touchdown, Blue Jays!
I need a great week of practice. We got Bennington at home. The worst thing you can do now is just sit and sulk. You got 8 games left in this season. 8 in the regular season. This game hurts. It's not that big of a deal now. We move forward. It's Bennington at our place.
Hey, yeah.
Hey, our goal 13 is not going
back
away.
To 13. Back to 13. Let's go. 13 on 3. 1, 2, 3.
13.
At Seward, we didn't come out very well. Weren't focused, I guess. Our DBs had troubles.
I think there was a lot in the game that we found out we need to work on and a lot that we can build off of, but there was also a lot of positives. So.
The players looked past their opening loss and moved on. Coach Williams asked for a good week of practice, and he got it. The team even practiced their pregame hype-up speech.
All right, boys! We have 4 quarters of Waverly Football! How many?
4!
How many?
4!
Ready? Begin!
we're hoping to establish the running game and just pound it down like we did last year and then throw in some passes when they're not ready.
There is no better group of young men that we want to be with right now than you. It's time to put everything on ourselves, take a deep breath, play our game.
The team needed to bounce back in front of their home crowd against Bennington and to prove they were better than how they performed against Seward.
Ride with the mob, alhamdulillah. Check in with me and do your job. Earth is the name, Bimbola did the chain. Tono for the watch, Prezi playing Jane. Yamagini chain, rest in peace.
The team totaled 620 yards of offense, and quarterback Rhett Jordan's 239 offensive yardage equaled that of the entire Bennington team in a 45-14 victory.
Well, right now it's a little rough with this rain for like the past week, but we're going to start prepping for them, and we think our weapons are better than theirs, so hopefully we play like it.
This week, Mother Nature forced the Vikings to head to the marker board instead of the locker room, something they'd have to get used to throughout the season.
Okay, so it's now what's in between your ears. And if you can sit there and really focus about what I need to do every single play, and you fix that, we're going to be just fine.
And plan is to go out there, do well, and we'll get the job done.
Ready, begin!
Let's go! I have no doubt in my mind that you're not prepared for this game. We had all these different outcomes this week. We practiced on a totally different field. We had to practice in the gym because of a rainstorm. We had to practice on a Monday because of Labor Day. So when you're out there doing your job, I want you to think about this. Your teammate is proud to be next to you, and he's proud that you are playing that play.
Going into their next game at Roncalli Catholic High School, Waverly looked to keep up its stride and only took one play. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Let's go. Let's go. Caleb Kanoya ran 70 yards on the first play of regulation to give the Vikings the start they were hoping for. A 28-3 halftime lead satisfied the Vikes for the time being, but the game wasn't over yet.
There you go! Oh!
Baseman!
Out of my racket!
Let's go!
safe to say the run game worked well for Waverly. The Vikings totaled 579 rushing yards in their 49-31 victory over Roncalli Catholic, just a few yards shy of the school record.
Mason, how are you feeling about the bus ride?
I'm excited, man. You know, I got my teammates around me, you know, just having a good time out here hanging out, you know.
178 miles separates Lexington and Waverly. The Vikings had a long road ahead of them and a must-win game if they wanted to make it to the playoffs.
It's nights like this that you let your guard down. It's nights like this that you don't prepare yourself here to get yourself ready for this game. It's nights like this that bad things happen because we're not prepared. Do your job. Play this play. Play this play. Our way. Play this play. Our way. Keep it in your mind.
We're gonna hit the field like all day long.
Let's go.
The Vikings scored almost every way possible, even returning a blocked punt. And of course, quarterback Rhett Jordan zigzagged his way through defenders like he had time and time again. Norris High School and Waverly High School are both Class B schools located just outside the capital city. No matter the sport, these two bitter rivals always try to one-up each other. The Norris Titans had been struggling, and on a beautiful homecoming night, the Vikings felt confident going into the game, the student section included.
I'm going to make this speech short and sweet. This is Norris. This is Norris. And if you're with me, and you're with these folks,
the Titans were held to 16 points as Waverly's defense refused to let anything through, and the offense refused to be stopped.
Hey, how are we preparing for the game today, Sawyer?
How are we preparing for the game?
Yeah.
Watching film.
The Vikings look to continue their winning streak as they face the 2-3 Cougars from Omaha Gross Catholic High School. A mild, cool afternoon gave the Vikings a perfect stage to ring the victory bell once again on their home field.
Let's go! Let's go!
Don't take a step back. Don't take a step back. Take this game and add momentum as we move forward. I need momentum. You need momentum. Let's take care of it.
Did not waste any time to put points on the board. After going for it on 4th and 9, senior Caleb Kenoyer punched his way into the end zone. Senior Jay Adams had 128 yards receiving, and the Vikes got their first shutout victory of the season over Omaha Gross.
Return in the ball carrier, touchdown, Vikings!
Heading into Week 7, Waverly now faced its biggest challenge of the regular season. The number one ranked Scott Catholic Skyhawks appeared in the state championship game in the previous season, and hadn't lost a game yet this year.
You know, I think we're just going to do what we do. I think we got a good chance. I think we run the ball at them. I think we can attack them. We use our speed, use our weapons, and I think we're going to be okay.
We're not changing much. We're just going to go pound them. You know, do everything we can to the best of our ability.
We've been wanting to play Scott for about 4 years now. Now we get to do it, so we're going to go do it.
A wet, chilly night was the setting for Waverly to put their game to the test. They needed to stay in this game if they wanted a real chance of ending up at Memorial Stadium.
Let me tell you how our program started. 5 years, I have watched this program grow. I have watched you guys grow from 7th and 8th graders to seniors, sophomores, juniors now. I've watched you grow, and you did it. The only way you know how, with the people that live in our community. I've watched you guys get knocked down. I've watched you guys get beat up. I have watched you guys get spit on, and I've watched you guys lose games you shouldn't lose. I've watched you guys do things happen to you that should never happen to you. I have watched it for 5 years. And there's something that you do that most people can't. You get right back up.
Let's play high school football! Go, go, go!
The Skyhawks got on the scoreboard with a safety after refusing to let Waverly's offense push forward. Waverly's luck changed after recovering not one but two fumbles while Scott was in their red zone. Later on in the half, Rhett Jordan dodged defenders as he threw up a Hail Mary to Jay Adams. The Vikings took the lead. But it was only the first half. Going into halftime, the Vikings were down by 3, but felt confident they could pull off an upset win. The speed of the Skyhawks became too much for Waverly in the second half. Waverly refused to let down. Rhett Jordan threaded a needle when he found Jay Adams once again for a touchdown. This, unfortunately, would be their last scoring drive of the game. Waverly lost their second game of the season, but the team felt they can now beat any team in Class B.
Omaha Scar game, it was definitely the most fun I've ever had in a game, but it sucked that we lost.
We had some mistakes, and then if we would have fixed those, we probably would have beat them.
The players had mixed feelings about having to practice inside once again because of the rain.
I feel good. Don't have to go outside, don't have to get wet. I'm just going to have fun inside.
It's rainy. I wish we were outside. Inside practice is not fun.
Well, it's cold outside, it's cold inside, it's just dry inside.
It was an eventful night for the Vikings at their home game against Plattsmouth. It was a pink-out night to raise awareness for breast cancer research. Waverly seniors were recognized before the game, and once again, incredibly wet. Despite the conditions, the Vikings wanted to put points on the board early.
Tonight's no different. You're going out there, and you're going to take your culture that you have built. And each one of your cultures is a little bit different, and that's what's beautiful about this team. Each one of your cultures is a little bit different, and they mesh so damn well. And you get to go out and play a game together and mesh your cultures together to build this program even stronger tonight. You get another opportunity.
Yearly tradition on senior night is the senior walk. The seniors walk arm in arm from one end of the field to the other to celebrate their dedication to the program. On a serene, gorgeous fall evening, the Vikings headed to Ralston for their final regular season game. Once again, the game plan was to put points on the board early, but this time the goal was to clinch a home playoff game in the first round. We gonna live it up, so give me the green light, 'cause I'm ready to go.
I'm so proud of you. I'm so proud that I get to coach you. I am so proud that I get to watch you play this game that I love dearly. You make me happy. I am here for you. And together, we're going to take care of business tonight.
Waverly's defense showed no mercy, and Rhett Jordan continued to weave through defenders and find targets through the air. Put my finger, got the game with me. Bang with me. Bought my purple ticket, got some brain on it. We used to kick it, how you hang on me? Hop in the Bentley coupe and blow the brains out. Let's go, baby, let's go!
Let's go! To do these things, gentlemen, all of you together, together, are unstoppable. That was a hell of a first season. We've got a second season to prepare for. We've got one mission. And three games to go.
Let's go, baby.
One mission, it, baby. Three games to go.
Hell yeah, baby.
Okay, let's get after it.
Yes, sir, baby. Let's go.
It was all celebrations for the players after their win. For the first time since 2009, the Waverly Vikings clinched a home playoff game. The 12th-seeded Minutemen from Lexington would find themselves traveling to Waverly this time around to play the 5th-seeded Vikings.
It hasn't happened for a while here at Waverly, so we're gonna make it. We're gonna make it fun.
You know. We just gotta stay focused. We played them before, but we really just gotta stay focused.
I feel pretty good.
It's gonna be cool.
Packed house.
It's gonna be awesome.
The scene was set. It was another beautiful night as an estimated 2,000 fans made their way to Viking Stadium. Having defeated Lexington earlier in the season, anything but a victory would mean failure.
Get it done and keep on going, all right? Get it done, keep on going. Establish ourselves early, get this done, go on in the next round, all right? Here we go, here we go.
Four!
How many?
Four!
Ready? Begin!
We got it!
Do it our way. Do it our way. Our way works. You see that. You're 7-2 for a reason, and that's because you did it our way. You have been doing it your way the exact same time. You're going after them. You're doing it the way we've taught you to do it. It is now time for you to take that and get after them and get in their ass. It is time for you to play Waverly our way. It is time for this to happen for this school, for you. You put
Waverly football's only state title came in 1980 with a 14-7 win over McCook. That was the last time the two teams met before the first round of the 2017 playoffs. The McCook Bison defeated Waverly 34-23 on a cold, harsh night. So when Waverly advanced to the quarterfinals only to find out they would be playing third-seeded McCook, you can bet revenge was the only thing on their mind.
All right, what's the game plan bonus to this?
Attack them.
Oh, dude, look at that.
We hit first.
We hit harder, we hit first, and we ride the buffalo. You're welcome.
The Vikings would find themselves traveling 3.5 hours to McCook just like last season. After taking roll and watching a parent's burnout, the Vikings were on their way. With plenty of time to spare, the players stopped at Kearney High School to burn off some energy and, of course, practice their kicking skills.
Thank you!
I just woke up, so it's been going pretty fast.
Yeah. Ready to go. Ready to go.
I'm really excited.
Pretty good right now. A little cold, but, you know, it's how it is sometimes.
So, good job out here. Let's go take care of business the rest of the way. Let's go have lunch and then get ready to go. Bring it in.
After eating lunch, the team was on their way. Next stop, McCook, Nebraska. The team arrived, followed by two buses full of students who paid to travel to the game. After getting taped up, the players hit the field to warm up on a mild, cloudy night. As per usual, the student section did not disappoint with their odd yet humorous signs. McCook won the toss, but let Waverly start with the ball. Game time was getting closer as head coach Tim Williams addressed the players once again before the most important game of the season so far.
And when you say it that way, win or go home, it should sink in. Now I think about a long time ago, you know, a group of young kids, and this is every single age in here. Because you all have done this. You've all gone through the system. You know, I watch you guys come up and go through the program and lift weights, push yourself past exhaustion. I see you go to camps. I see you struggle. I see you overcome adversity. I see you fall to adversity. I've seen it all from you. Every single one of you have been on a roller coaster ride your high school career so far. The ups and the downs, they've been fun at times, and not so fun as well. That's life. The ups and downs, that's where we go. That's what happens to us. That's everybody in here. That's every single person in here, whether it be a coach, whether it be a player, whether it be a manager. The ups and the downs. Win or go home. This is what we are here for. Win or go home. Every single one of you in this room was made for this moment. You were made for this moment. And it doesn't matter the sport. It matters what you're doing. It matters that you're strapping on pads with your brothers and that you're going to go do something together. Win or go home. It is win or go home. You want this, it goes through McCook. It has to go through McCook. Why not? We lost last year to these guys. That's our down. I'm tired of listening about them. It's time that we write our own chapter, and it starts here in McCook.
Deciding to let Waverly start with the ball was a decision the Bison would regret. On the first play of the game, Rhett Jordan ran 70 yards down the sideline before being tackled. Just two plays later, he found the end zone, letting McCook know they were here to play.
Tackle!
The Bison answered with not one or two, but three touchdowns in the first quarter alone, leading the Vikings 20-7. With the season on the line, Waverly needed to improve their focus in the second quarter. Safe to say the second quarter was the improvement for the Waverly Vikings. Scores on back-to-back drives made it a two-point game. Rhett Jordan threw an interception to give the Bison a field goal chance to end the first half, a chance they missed, letting the Vikings go to the locker room on a positive note. Defense reigned in the third quarter. Neither team was able to put any points on the board. The Vikings were still down by two going to the fourth quarter. Now was win or go home. On third and one at their own 20-yard line, junior Mason Neiman ran 80 yards thanks to a huge block by Jay Adams to give the Vikings the lead. Waverly's defense forced McCook to punt once again. The Bison had no answer for Waverly's no-huddle offense in the fourth quarter. Like they'd done numerous times before, Rhett Jordan handed the ball off to Caleb Kinnoyer to extend Waverly's lead with 4 minutes to go. McCook wasn't done yet. With only 2 minutes to go, the Bison punched in a touchdown to make it a one-score game. Jay Adams secured the onside kick for Waverly, but they couldn't find a first down, forcing them to give the ball right back to McCook. It was now do or die for McCook. On third and 10, Ben Carter nearly intercepted the ball, but McCook had one more play left in the dying seconds of the game. Making up for his previous interception, Rhett Jordan intercepted Cam Berry's pass to secure the game for Waverly. First time since 2004, Waverly football was moving on to the semifinals. It was time to get back to work for the Vikings. Making it this far in the season brought some new challenges. The team now had to practice under the lights at the stadium because the sun was setting sooner, which also meant practice would be much colder. Quarterback Rhett Jordan didn't practice for much of the week to help heal his knee injury.
I feel about practice on the field.
Our beautiful QBs just got set.
The team had an even bigger challenge in the form of undefeated Scott Catholic Skyhawks.
It's going to be a good game between two very good Class B football teams.
I'm feeling really good. Home field advantage, let's get it!
Feels really good because all the fans are going to be here. We're going to put on a show for them.
About a half inch of snow fell Thursday night to make Waverly's home semifinal game even more interesting. The players kept warm inside until they had no choice but to bundle up for the game, some even putting hand warmers in their cleats. The sun had fallen over the horizon before the teams began warming up. The brave student section of Waverly wasn't going to let the freezing temps keep them from supporting the team. Oh, and holding up more signs. Coach Williams had a simple message for his team before their last home game of the season.
Play with your hearts. Play with your hearts. And understand that you love each and every single one of you in here with your heart. You were born to play this game. You're good at this game. Love one another and play each play with your heart.
Neither team scored in the first quarter. The biggest defensive play came when junior Barrett Skrebecki stopped the Skyhawks on a 4th-and-1 near the end zone. Thatcher Kozel recovered a fumbled snap for the Vikings, but Waverly couldn't get a first down. Scott fumbled the ball again, giving Waverly another chance, but a failed fake field goal gave Scott a chance to score with seconds left in the half. A chance that ended with a touchdown for the Skyhawks. After halftime, the Skyhawks scored on their opening two possessions, giving them a 21-0 lead. Waverly hadn't backed down all season, and they weren't going to now. Waverly had been down 2 touchdowns in their previous victory over McCook, but unfortunately that wasn't going to be the case this time around.
This is never easy. I've been around great football players. I've been around great teams, not necessarily football teams, but I've been around great teams. This is the greatest football team I have ever coached in my life. Perfect. Our play calling? No, not always. Were you perfect in your execution? No, not always. But what makes you the best team that I've ever coached is how much you love playing with one another. How much of a drive you had for one another.